So a great way to move files around in the Finder is to use copy and paste. Now you probably know how to use drag and drop to move files, and that's the standard way to do it. But dragging and dropping can be tough in some situations. Like for instance, here I've got some folders, and let's look in the docs folder here. And I've got a milestones.rtf. Now let me go back here and then say I want to move that into the miscellaneous folder. Great, so it's two different locations. So how do I drag and drop from inside this folder to inside that folder? Well, one way to do it might be to go in here, then I'm going to create a new Finder window, and then I'll go here, and now I can drag and drop between the two Finder windows. But you can see there are a lot of steps involved there. So an easier way to do it is to copy and paste. So I select this file here and I choose Edit Copy or just Command C. Now I go to the second location here and I can go to Edit Paste or Command V. I paste it in and the file appears there. Now this actually performs a copy. If we go back here and look in the docs, you can see it's still there. So what if we actually wanted to move? You would think the way to do that would be to use Cut and then paste. I mean, that's the way it works in other situations like editing text or images. And I think other operating systems have a cut command. Well, you can't do that in Mac OS. It actually works a little bit better than that because cutting is kind of not a good idea. You're removing the file. What if you're interrupted and you never get to paste it somewhere? The file now doesn't exist. Let me go and delete this file here. We'll go back in here and I'm going to go in here and copy again. It's all I can really do is copy. That's fine. So now I actually don't even have to decide at that point whether I'm going to paste and make a new copy of it or move it. When I go in here, I go to Edit, I can go Paste, but if I hold down the Option key, you could see it changes to Move Item here. And the keyboard shortcut instead of Command V is Option Command V. So you simply do Option Command V instead of Command V, and there's that file. And if I go back to the original folder, you can see it's gone. So you can copy and paste to copy a file to a new location, and you can copy and then Option Command V paste to move it there. The great thing about copying and pasting to move files is it doesn't have to just be one file. I can select a whole bunch of files. I can copy those, move to another location, and paste those or Option Command V paste to move them there. So it's a great tool, and once you start doing this, you actually start using this as the primary way that you move files around in the Finder.